What's going on, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to get back on the G550 Mercedes G-Wagon, but before we start back on that, I want to show you guys something absolutely amazing. Check this thing out. Oh my goodness, this car right here, man, hold on guys, this right here is a dream build. Now, you know me, I'm not a big S2000 fan, but I'm a huge carbon fiber fan, and look at that, man. Oh my goodness, the entire car is carbon fiber, real carbon fiber. Doors, hood, fenders, front bumper. I don't know why, I probably would have painted this like black or something, or possibly wrapped it, but that thing still looks absolutely insane. Look at these rays, man. Brembo brakes, oh my, and guess what? I'm pretty sure, I'm about 99.99% sure there's a big old fat Paxton Pro Charger under there. I would open the hood and show you guys, but you know, cars, man, they're like women, and you would never touch another man's woman without his permission. Look at the seats, man. He's got these bride bucket seats. I bet them things just grab your booty, man. Carbon all up inside there. The whole dashboard's carbon. He's got like a custom a speedometer thing, cluster majigger thing, got like a screen in there. Look at that steering wheel, man. This thing's a straight up bona fide race car. Look, compared to a stock S2000, look at the difference, guys. Just look at the difference. Stock, modified. Pretty sexy. All right, guys, let's get to work. Guys, I got the G-Wagon up on the I got it up on the frame rack. I guess it kind of is a frack. It's a frame and it's a rack. So we got it up on the frack and we are about to tie this thing down. I've been a little bit busy. I did have to clean up the entire shop before I got started. I'm running a couple of other jobs. I got two more vehicles that I need to pull in right there. I need to get the Jag boosted off and get the Ranger charged up and get them moved in. Alrighty, that's enough chit chat. Let's get this thing up on the frame machine, get it strapped down and start pulling on this frame rail. Guys, look at this frame rail. Oh my goodness. I do not know what is going to happen here, but hopefully it comes out and we don't have to replace this entire frame, because if we have to replace this entire frame, that's going to be not only expensive, but take a lot more time. So hopefully we can get this thing pulled out. So as you guys can see, I've got all the blocks and the chains on the G-Wagon, and I actually get a lot of questions about the way that I strap the vehicles down onto the frame rack. A lot of people ask me why I use the blocks, why I use the chains. First of all, this is a full frame vehicle. So that means that it has an actual frame that is separated from the actual body itself. And that means that to put it up onto the clamps, you would have to have special attachments, and it's actually pretty fairly complicated. Also, if you look, this frame is a lot more narrow than the frame machine. So you would not be able to even use the actual clamps that come with this frame machine. You would still have to put it up onto these blocks. And so the way that I chain it down, if you look right here, you see that big main crossbeam, and I have that chain kind of wrapped around it and going back to the front. That right there, along with this chain right here and these two chains back here, will keep this thing from going anywhere, and it will not damage the frame at all. Usually I spend at least an hour clamping a car down, getting it strapped down, and making sure that when I start pulling, it doesn't even move a half a centimeter. So it's very important. A lot of people will throw one or two chains on it and, you know, start bending the frame in other areas while they are pulling. I've never had that happen to me. As hard as that might be to believe, I've never damaged a frame like that. So, you know, I'm going to continue doing it the way I'm doing it. And until I get a new frame rack with all the new accessories, this is how we are going to do it. So check this out, guys. This frame is, whew, oh man. So what I need to do right now, I need to
go ahead and you know, do a little bit of pulling on it and possibly go ahead and get rid of this apron, take that off, get it all stripped down. The reason why I didn't want to take it apart before is because I want to pull this apron and try to save this inner structure. It looks like it's a little bit bent, but it also looks like it may come out. I don't know 100% if that's going to straighten out, but we will see. And hopefully everything straightens out and looks really good. The problem is that for me to get this frame rail pulled out 100%, I have to heat it. And to heat it, I have to remove the apron. And to remove the apron, I need to pull the apron. So, you know, it's kind of like a little Mexican standoff. We're over here just pointing pistols at each other. But we're going to get it done. We're going to get it done. I promise you. So what I want to do is I want to go ahead and do a little preliminary pull just to see how bad it's going to be and to see if it's actually going to pull fairly easy or if it's going to need a whole bunch of heat. We're going to try to pull it out on cold first and see if we can't straighten this apron out a bit. And then if everything starts looking good, I'm going to try to continue pulling it. If not, we'll go ahead and just remove this apron and toss it and get a new one. And then, you know, we'll put some heat to that rail and get it pulled out. So I'm going to swing that boom around over here. We're going to get started. Check this out. Hey, the hood closed. Ooh, buddy, that's a tough frame. Buddy, that's a tough frame. She's definitely gonna need some heat, boys. She's gonna need some heat. So as you guys seen, it does not necessarily want to go very easily. I honestly was not expecting it to. These cars right here are pretty tough. The frame is a fully boxed German beast mode, whatever the heck it's made out of, some kind of crazy supersonic nuclear steel. And if you look at this apron right here, man, this thing is just done. It should be like right here. And if I try to pull it out, I'd have to remove this bolt right here and pull it out. But the problem is if you can see how it's kind of deformed, it's gonna be very hard to get that right. So I think that we just need to replace it. Like I said, it's a higher end vehicle and it is all pretty jacked up everywhere. It's bent all the way back here. And so I think the best course of action is going to be replacing that apron. So I'm going to go ahead and get the apron removed. I'm going to go ahead and get all the radiators off of it. And then we are going to isolate this frame rail and add some heat to it and see what happens. Guys, check this key out. This is the key to this S2000 I showed you guys this morning. And here's the owner. Andrew just pulled up. He's picking it up. And I'm gonna let him tell you guys a little bit about it because this is such a freaking awesome build that it just blows me away, man. All the carbon and
so yeah, it's been a lot of fun. Bought it 10 out of 10 VIN car, AP1. So some people would say I ruined it, but started out I was gonna keep it stock and did some Olin suspension on it, and then I ended up crashing the car slightly. So at that point it was like, Let's do everything. So I started carbon trunk, carbon hood, put the Volk TE37s and they're the OG TE37s. Did a big brake kit on the front. carbon fenders, carbon doors, carbon spoon mirrors, carbon half lip, and then I supercharged it with a Speed of Science supercharger with AM standalone engine management. So at 12 pounds of boost, it's making 440 wheel horsepower and 270 foot-pounds of torque.
So wow.
Got a lot of stuff from JD Customs. As far as all their titanium goodies, some parts from Renegade and some rare Password JDM parts as well, as far as the carbon bits. So, and then I have a top secret oil cap, which is probably one of 10 in the United States.
So wow.
That's a really rare piece, but yeah, full-blown radiator, spall fans, carbon APR, coolant cover here. And then this, my friend Kevin Shanahan made that in titanium for the intake, because it comes with a little plastic piece. Even like the oil filter housing, it's got a Renegade titanium spin-off plate. So if you rev it to 9,000 RPMs, it doesn't back off. It's a great car.
Yeah, this right here is a build. This is when somebody says I built it, this right here is a build. Wow, and is that screen, is that made specifically for
this
car?
It's for the AM, yeah. Well, it's not made for the car, so you have to make the whole carbon piece was custom made for that to fit it in the
car. Oh, wow. Who made the carbon?
So a guy named Joe Dirt 2K over in Texas sent him the screen, and he has a S2000, and he's amazing with carbon work, and Joe's the man.
You need a sticker for the Prius that says, you should see my other car.
I should. You know, they have a sticker I've seen on them that says, cool car never, or said no one or something, which is true, but everybody needs a Prius.
Yeah, you know they have that cooling problem.
So on mine,
It's not cool to drive it.
Oh, that too. Yes, that is... Yeah, nobody ever said, oh, that's a sweet-looking Prius.
Hey, but that money that you're saving...
Yeah, it allows me to have shit like this.
Yes, sir. Let's see it, man. I want to hear this thing. Man, look at this thing, guys. This thing is so sexy. Makes me want a lawnmower. Did it match up good, sir?
Yeah, it looks perfect. It was perfect paint job. Holy cow.
Hey, you know you came to the right spot, like I told you before.
Yes, sir.
What are you gonna do with it? You gonna drag race it?
Line it up, drag race it.
You gonna drag race it? The man over there in that Honda S2000 said he could gap this thing. He said do it right now for $1,000. Right now.
Hired by SRT, buddy.
SRT. Let me tell you something, guys. This car is a giant learning curve for me. But anyways, check this out. We got the apron pulled out just a hair. Look at that. Look at the distance. Look at that distance right there. You see that? We use that clamp a holy right there. Big old clamp. Of course, you know, I've got my sockets welded onto there because people keep stealing these things, man. That Pittsburgh stuff, it's expensive. We're gonna probably remove that clamp here in a second, but what I wanted to do was get these radiators off, and I just want to show you guys like how intricate and how complex this vehicular is. Like, if you just like look at it, like really look at what you're looking at and know what you're looking at, you'll know that a lot of stuff has to come off for a little bit of stuff to come off, and then more stuff has to come off for a lot of stuff to come off, and then a little bit of stuff needs to come off for a lot of stuff to come off, and so basically the whole thing has to come off. Look, we are looking for, where are they at? Somewhere, there should be lines. We're looking for lines. I don't know where they go. This is crazy. This is a conundrum. Look at this, watch this. This right here, I don't know what this is, Wi-Fi or something. These two lines, okay, look, I'm gonna wiggle them, right? No movement anywhere. You can't see anything, right? Can't see anything. Okay, we come over here. Where are the lines? They're gone. Do you guys see the lines? I don't see the lines. I need somebody to go over there and wiggle them. Oh, all right. Hold on. Yeah. That's them right there. Look. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. All right, where did they go? Who knows? Okay, so. Oh. Okay. It's these two probably. I think this fender's got to come off. I got a new fender for it anyways. So I'm going to go ahead and remove this fender, and we'll keep going. Where is it going? Alignment shop. Hey, I like that shifter, man.
The shifter is sick. It's short throw.
What is that, mahogany or is that teak?
That's plastic.
Oh, shoot. Let her rip, man. Let her rip. I've had so many different distractions throughout the day. So many different people coming over here messing with me. But at least I got this fender off. And I'm trying to get this radiator off. I'm just having some trouble down here with this clamp. I'm gonna get my hose clamp tool, and then it's kind of smashed in. I've been trying to separate it and really can't. So I gotta get this line off, and then, you know, just kind of take it off in pieces, maybe take off that condenser first and then keep digging at it, you know? Also, to remove this apron, I have to remove that box. I don't know what that box is, but it looks like a lot of work. So I don't know. I don't know if I'm gonna do that today, honestly. You know, I got a bunch of other stuff I gotta still do. So this thing might have to just wait for a hot little second, but we're not gonna give up. So I've been looking at how to remove this apron, and I don't know, but pretty sure it's just these two bolts right here, and then this whole thing will probably just fall off. But I don't know for sure. I'm gonna try to unscrew those and see what happens. Guys, the trick to productivity is to have a impact for every situation. And have the right tips, obviously. Oh boy, I think the hood might need to come off, man. Go ahead and pull that hood off, partner. What are you waiting for? Just remove it, man. Dang, son, quit playing. One thing I love about that Mercedes, man, you unscrew that thing and it just stays right there in its spot. Walking away.
falling in love as she's walking away. Winger, Mark will tell you. Tell your mouth what it should say.
Don't go falling in love. Oh, yeah.
Drain pot.
Drain pot. Pot.
Drain pot.
Drain pot. That sounds like your ex-boyfriend's band.
Alrighty, we got the box off. Look at this big old gaping hole. Oh my goodness, we gotta stick our hands in there. We got our Impacto right here. And you always want to make sure that you lose every single bolt. Like literally. Just lose every single bolt. I'm just kidding. If you don't know it's a joke, then I don't think you should be watching my videos because like get yourself in trouble. Oh no. You see that? You got to pay attention. You got to pay attention in school. Oh, you got to pay attention in school. Oh, she's wet, bro. She's spewing everywhere. Oh, man. She got me all wet. Giggity. Anyways, what's next? What's next, bud? What's next? This right here? Let's pop it. I was just messing with you guys. The one kind of like not cool thing about BMWs or Mercedes is that a lot of their stuff is on these zip ties right here that are like kind of a pain in the butt, honestly. They are such a pain in the butt. It's like not even funny. I'm gonna have to put the phone down. So of course, when I put the phone down, I'm going to be all super slick with it and get it off without breaking anything and look super professional without you guys seeing it. But it is what it is. You guys believe me. All right. What's next? What is next, mate? These got these little clip coppers right here. Pop! Caught my fingers. See this clip right here? It's an interesting clip right here. Watch this. So what you want to do is get right there dead center on it like that. Bam! Shove it in there. And then that will cause these things to get smaller. See, now watch this. Oh! See that? And it makes that little noise too. And then this, you have to do that. You see? You see how professional do it with one hand? With one hand, you do not know this kind of stuff. Look at this. This is how pro do it. All right, look at this. What is this? You think we need this? I don't even think we need this, man. I think I can just delete this. Who needs air conditioning? Anybody that gets a G-Wagon needs to humble themselves anyways. So maybe just drive around without no AC for just a little bit, you know? Really get that peasant feeling, and then we'll put that line back on there once you're good and right. Anyways, I'm gonna get all this stuff off and I'm gonna rip this stupid apron off finally. Guys, check that out. I got the apron off and look at this shock, man. It's like not even connected at the top. Look, it's not even in the bushing, man. Let's see if I can't bust this thing loose right quick. Oh, it's gotta come way back. Okay, I gotta take that off. But bro, I definitely did make a mistake. I forgot that I didn't support the axle. And my mortal self sustained a small injury, just but a scratch. This side as well. Both hands, I was kind of hugging it. You can kind of see it in the time lapse.
But yeah, don't do that. Don't unscrew the shock unless you have that being supported. I was more worried about these lines getting damaged than I was myself, because you know me, it's hard to kill me. But them lines right there, them lines are expensive. So yeah, we've opened it up quite a bit. And the reason why I was trying to take the shock off is because, first of all, we need a new shock. Second of all, how am I supposed to get in there and do some pulling if we don't take that floppy thing out of the way? Look at that. It's gotta be replaced anyways. Most likely gonna need a new spring too. You know, these springs, they'll bend. Even though it is spring steel, it's still like, it will bend. If it got hit hard enough, it'll bend. Best thing to do is replace it. But yeah, we're moving right along. Moving right along. Next step is to get rid of the radiators and probably eat lunch, even though it's like already 3:30. So I'm gonna go eat and then I will jump right back on it. Guys, this right here is a huge milestone on this repair, on this build. Getting all this apart has exposed absolutely everything that is damaged. As you guys can see, we have a lot more bumper bracketry there that's bent. I think there's like one or two extra pieces here that we need to order, as well as the apron mount or whatever that thing is. I don't know what it is. Piece of rubber with metal and a bolt through it. But anyways, that's good. You know, we a couple more things need to be removed and then we are going to start pulling. And we're not too worried about all this stuff right now, because you know, we can pull the frame out, make sure everything's square, you know, make sure the wheels are sitting straight and everything. And because it is a full frame, so you know, I can just straighten it. And then we'll get the fenders on it, we'll get the hood on it. Man, I'm so excited, guys. You don't even know. So the reason why I'm super excited about getting this thing done is because of everything that's in these boxes. I'm not really going to tell you just yet what is in these boxes, but I promise you, when you see what is in there, you will be very, very happy, I guess. I don't know. You probably won't care, but who cares? You know, who cares? It's all just metal and plastic and water. You know, I'm about 65% water. What are you doing, man?
I'm trying to go home.
Oh, for real? Dang, this thing looks so good. What'd you say? It's a single stage? What made you do a single stage? Is it just preference?
Because I had a gallon of white. Now, this car is for our accountant. I don't know why he wants this car, but apparently he loves these cars. He's got two of them. We got a white one and a black one. And so we're kind of, you know, helping him out. So, when I was able to get some free paint, then...
Well, he is from Africa, so I know why he likes this car. These cars over there are super popular. Where is he from exactly?
Kenya.
He's from Kenya, man. Shout out to Kenya. Big shout out to Kenya, man. I know you guys love these cars over there, if anybody's watching from Kenya. Man, look at this. This thing is slick. I don't see any trash in it at all. Maybe just a couple of like light pieces of trash. Some stuff that maybe fell out of your hair. Nah, don't you wear that helmet? I need to record you wearing that helmet, man. Dang, I gotta get out of here before I mess something up. You know, somebody said I'm a bull in a china shop.
Don't prove them right.
I told them I identify as a bull. All right, bro, I gotta go. So I did start on the flag wall. As you guys can see, I've got a good bit of flags up there. And let me explain to you guys a little bit of the order that's going on here and what's going on here. So first of all, I've only went to a little bit over halfway because I want to give the people whose flag is not up there yet a chance to get up on the top row you know, with the big dogs up there. The reason why I chose the United States to be up there first is simply because we're top dog. You know what I mean? Great Britain's second. I mean, we won the Revolutionary War, so that's kind of self-explanatory. And then we got Germany there, of course. They almost got us in the war, so big mad respect to them. They get to be third. Japan, of course, also mad props to you guys. You guys did a lot. I guess you didn't really do enough, but in the end, we're all good friends, right? Then we got China. You guys know I love China. China's the greatest country ever. Come on now. Xi Jinping. No, I'm kidding. I love China. Alibaba, eBay, come on now. You cannot deny. Then we got Ukraine. Good old Ukraine. Hold up in there, buddy. Hang in there. Hang in there, man. I don't know if you guys noticed, I swapped Russia with Australia simply because it's Australia, mate. Come on, mate. It's Australia. I love Australia, man. I'm sorry I butcher your guys' language all the time, but it is what it is, mate. Crikey. Crow about it. Anyways, then we got Russia. Of course, you know, I'm still good friends with Russia, whatever. Putin, you know, he's just trying to, I don't know, he's an idiot. Anyways, Canada, you're right there. You keep an eye on that one. You know, maybe set up a couple more artillery shells or something. Drop in the comment section below where you want your flag. I guess if you're not up there, you get to choose. If I put the flag, if I put your country's flag upside down, or if your country's flag is not up there, drop your flag in the emojis. This is a art piece in progress. This art piece right here is going to be worth millions of dollars one day. I promise you. I kid you not. I wouldn't lie to you. I wouldn't piss on your back till you're training, but I really wouldn't. But anyways, if you're not happy with the placement of your flag, then you're just crap butt out of luck, man. I don't know what else to tell you. I guess come down here and let's fight. I don't know. No, I'm just kidding, guys. We're all peaceful. That's why we're all going up here. And eventually this entire thing will be full of everybody that watches the channel. And possibly, you know, we'll get more people watching the channel because of the flag. People will look at it and be like, whoa, is that my flag up there? Is that my flag? But it's my flag. I'm just kidding.
That's gonna be it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, smash that like button. It's like, it's way down there. Well, it's not way down there, but you know, it's right there. Super easy. Looks kind of like my thumb. Beep, beep. Drop a comment in the comment section below. Any advice, tips, ideas. I don't know. Maybe I'm doing something weird or wrong. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace out. After hanging up all those flags on the wall, I realized that I had all these extra plastic straws that were serving as flag poles for the little miniature flags. And I decided I'm going to do something super creative with it. And I'm going to dump all these plastic straws into the ocean to create an aquatic environment for